I've guest taught a comedy class at some colleges, and one of the things that I always tell the students is the worst that can happen on stage is getting booed. And I want to apologize for lying to them. We're at Fairfield University, in basically the on-campus pub. There are these guys who are way too old to be in college, who
50.
Are at the bar.
50?
50? Yeah.
50?
50. Easy. Easy 50. 50 is a compliment. They're just yelling. Just straight up yelling. So I go over to the bartender and I say, hey, can you quiet those guys down? And she said, well, I can't because it's a bar. They're allowed to do what they want. And I said, well, if they're loud, this is going to be a shitty show. That's your choice.
So then I went on stage.
I had to ask the bartender to shut the TV off.
I didn't even notice, like an idiot. And then, yeah, in the middle of my joke, she was walking behind me and turned off the TV. That felt good.
My favorite part of your set was when the dude in the trench coat, the 50-year-old dude in the trench coat and the open backpack, sauntered through the crowd and walked in front of the stage.
You could describe it as bombing. I think bombing's a good word for it.
I don't think bombing's the word, because to bomb, you have to have a shot.
It was bad, but I figured if there was a man up to the challenge, it was Steve Hostetter.
This is no reflection on Fairfield University. This is no reflection on the town of Fairfield. This is five isolated assholes doing what they do best.
They were so drunk and very big that I was concerned for you. But it was a very brave, It was a brave show. I consider the show, I would consider it a brave night for the both of us.
I love when the guy was like, give me the microphone. Fuck you, give you the microphone.
And he was like, I know where you live, and then ran into a couch.
oh, that was the best part. And when he left and we were like, oh, he's finally done, then he starts banging on the window. And then they came back. They came back.
Yeah.
There wasn't, I guess they had been kicked out of all the dorms and perhaps the preschools.
Yep. There were a lot of exits and entrances. They kept coming in, and like every time that Steve would be like, all right, they're gone, one would come back in and be like, oh, nope, we're back.
I offered to buy $100 worth of drinks for everyone in the crowd. So yeah, as long as she kicked them out, and she said no.
Yeah, I mean, we both did it. Like at the end of the day, we both made it through.
I sold a CD.
CD?
So yeah, I sold a CD.
That's like being there the night Siegfried and Roy got hit by the tiger. It's like, well, we did see a show.
Sure.
We saw Siegfried and Roy live.
Briefly.
And then we saw them bleed in front of
and
us.
And we saw Siegfried live. Because I have so many heckler videos on YouTube, people will often comment things like, oh, this guy sure gets heckled a lot. And it's not true. Any comic who does as many shows as we do will get heckled. Because those five guys, they weren't there for me. They weren't there for comedy. They were there to try to matter. For a split second in their life, to feel like they were not insignificant. And instead, they made a room of people fucking hate them. That's why hecklers exist. And it wouldn't matter if it was Louis C.K. up there, or George Carlin, or zombie George Carlin. Those guys would have been pricks, no matter who was on that stage. Because those guys started as pricks, they will end as pricks. And hopefully, soon enough,
don't say it,
they will die as pricks.
I just want to say, I think if I had another 5 minutes with them, I could have won them over.